What would happen if an American soldier and a North Korean soldier found themselves face to face on the field of battle? Who would win? It would most likely come down to the soldier with the best training and equipment. Both soldiers would be well versed in combat, but who would have an edge? Let's compare an American Army soldier to a North Korean soldier from head to toe and see who might have the upper hand. Becoming a soldier is different in every country, but the path to becoming a soldier in the United States versus in North Korea are two totally different ends of the spectrum. In the United States, you can talk to a recruiter who will take you under their wing for enlistment. You're allowed to ask questions, and the recruiter is happy to discuss joining the Army in person, over the phone, or in email. The process is easy but informative. This way, you can find out if the Army is right for you. The antithesis of this process is joining the North Korean military. Every North Korean citizen must join the military. It is not optional. The US may have the most powerful military in the world, but no one is forced to serve at this moment in time. The same cannot be said for the Korean People's Army. If you're born in North Korea, you better believe at some point you'll be a soldier. After being recruited into the US Army, the soldier goes through basic combat training. All soldiers must go through this process. In the training, they learn the basics of survival and teamwork. American soldiers are put through scenarios in real-life combat situations. They must pass physical and mental challenges that will allow them to complete missions in any type of hostile environment. The American soldier is trained by veterans and military personnel who are equipped to prepare them for combat. This is to ensure that they can meet the highest standards. North Korean soldiers also go through difficult training. Unfortunately for the Korean People's Army, there are many social and economic obstacles for soldiers to overcome during basic training. Several reports have provided evidence that although the training is rigorous for North Korean soldiers, oftentimes malnourishment and corruption hinders the abilities of the soldiers to complete their training. It would seem that the trainers and teachers are oftentimes more focused on their own needs than those of their recruits. This would negatively affect North Korean soldiers' capability during a battle. Time served in each country is also vastly different. In the United States military, a soldier is required to provide service for 4 years. They can always extend their tours or rejoin after their assigned time is up, but 4 years is required once enlisted. In the North Korean military, men must serve 10 years, women serve 7 years, and if you're lucky enough to be part of Kim Jong-un's personal bodyguard, you must serve for 13 years. If you're an American soldier, the government will oftentimes support or pay for your college education after you serve. In North Korea, citizens can go to college, but the military does not provide direct assistance. Normally, a North Korean will defer military enlistment until after college, but they still must serve their country in the military regardless. This does not seem like the best incentive for the happiness or well-being of soldiers in the North Korean military. But if you're fortunate enough to go to college and get a degree, you only need to serve for 5 years. Unless you get a degree in science or engineering, then service only lasts 3 years. Apparently, it pays to be a scientist in North Korea. After basic training for a US soldier, they move into advanced individual training. This is where the soldier's skills and expertise are developed so that they can be the best soldier possible. The US Army describes this training as the time you'll learn the skills to perform your Army job. Whatever job that might be, a US Army soldier can be sure they'll receive training and guidance in their field. The same cannot be said about North Korean soldiers. They receive basic training, and they are immediately assigned a detail. No further training required or offered. They're on their own. The requirements and training for each soldier up to this point seem to be vastly different. At the end of the training regimen, the American soldier has been given incentives and special training, while the North Korean soldier has been forced to enlist for many years with no special training. The American soldier seems to have the advantage thus far. The United States Army prides itself on providing a comfortable lifestyle for their soldiers. The Army makes it clear that a soldier's duties are to uphold the Constitution and protect American freedoms. And just like all United States citizens, soldiers are given free time to spend with their families and friends, as well as take part in other interests. The Army provides soldiers with access to education, housing, health insurance, and other basic necessities. The same cannot be said about how the North Korean government treats their soldiers. Accounts of superiors turning a blind eye when their soldiers are being abused or in need of help is common. Also, bribes are a norm when in the military. Soldiers who have escaped North Korea have said that military personnel would take bribes and threaten citizens with jail time if they did not pay. But this different mentality is rooted in the lack of basic living necessities that North Korean soldiers have. Unlike the American soldiers, there's no continuing education for the soldiers of North Korea. No top-of-the-line hospitals or health facilities, and housing conditions are not maintained to adequate basic living standards. Worst of all, most accounts coming out of North Korea state that the soldiers, just like the citizens, are malnourished and underfed. It's been reported that soldiers in the special units are taken care of. However, as one defector recounted, the average soldier is only given 2 or 3 potatoes a meal, or are fed solely on raw corn kernels or corn rice. It would seem that the lifestyle of the two soldiers are different in almost every way. To be a formidable combatant, you must be in good health. How does the US soldier stack up against a North Korean soldier when it comes to physical fitness and health standards? Well, it would seem that the American soldier has an advantage here as well. The Army has several programs to support the health of their soldiers. There are specialists that aid American soldiers with safety while exercising, physical fitness trainers that ensure the soldier is working out properly, food specialists that help maintain a healthy diet, and facilities to encourage and support soldiers exercising. The US military takes the lifestyle and health of their soldiers very seriously when they're in the Army. Conversely, the North Korean government does not always take the fitness or nutrition aspect of their soldiers' lives as seriously as one would expect. The biggest difference between the two soldiers is nutrition. North Korean soldiers that have defected and later explained what it was like being a soldier in North Korea often bring up a lack of food. Regular soldiers are almost always malnourished and look for any way to get more food. There are reports of North Korean soldiers having parasites due to lack of sanitation as well. One account states that whenever a soldier becomes too malnourished to carry out their duties, they're sent home to recover with their family. However, the lack of nutrition and poor lifestyle of most families leads to that soldier remaining malnourished or worse. Nutrition and fitness play a role in the body stature of a soldier. North Korean soldiers are several inches shorter than the average American soldier. Lack of nutrition and fitness also has reduced the body and muscle mass of North Korean soldiers. Being a soldier in any country is hard work. However, it would seem being a soldier in North Korea is a whole other level of hard, due to the lack of willingness by the government to take care of health and lifestyles of their soldiers. Two soldiers can be equally well-trained, but the equipment they have might give them an advantage in a fight. Let's now compare the equipment of an American soldier to that of a North Korean soldier. We'll start at the head and work our way down. The United States is consistently upgrading and improving their equipment for their soldiers. The standard-issue helmet for a US soldier is no different. The American soldier is outfitted with an integrated head protection system. This helmet is made of materials that are lightweight but still protect the soldier's head from bullets and flying debris. According to the head engineer, the helmet is created to be 100% more effective at protecting the American soldier than previous versions. That is impressive. The North Korean helmet is slightly less sophisticated. The standard-issue helmet is made entirely of steel. The helmets come either from what was formerly the Soviet Union or a North Korean-made version that is very similar. This would suggest that the helmets of the North Korean soldier have not been updated in several decades, leading to a less capable head protection unit. The United States soldier also receives protection for their body. Each US soldier is given a modular, scalable vest as body armor. The newest model is 5 pounds lighter than the previous standard-issue body armor. American soldiers can also request to be outfitted with the ballistic pelvic protector for additional protection on the lower body. On top of the body armor, the American soldier also receives a combat shirt that is designed to protect the soldier from fire. A regular North Korean soldier is given no body armor at all. It is reported that high-ranking officers and special forces may receive some body protection, but the average soldier's body is only protected by their canvas uniform. Not ideal when in a battle. What about boots? Maybe North Korean soldiers have boots that are specially made to grip the ground and protect their feet and ankles? It would seem that this is not the case either. Although many US soldiers prefer to buy their own non-government-issued boots, the US Army has been putting a lot of time and resources into designing the best footwear possible for these soldiers. North Korean soldiers, on the other hand, often get used or low-quality boots to wear. The design has not changed for several decades. It would seem that the American soldier has the North Korean beaten in terms of lifestyle, health, and combat attire. But what about weapons? North Korea is run by a dictator as a military state. They pump billions of dollars into their military programs, so maybe it's all going to standard-issue weapons on the North Korean soldier. There are several standard-issue pistols for an American soldier to choose from. It often depends on the soldier's role and preferences as to which gun they end up with. Most of the pistols at the American soldier's disposal are 9mm. Soldiers receive the M17 or M18, which are designed to reduce jamming and provide a more durable weapon. North Korean soldiers are most often given older models of pistols, such as the Browning M1900, the Russian Makarov pistol, or PM, and Russian TT-30A. Again, these guns were state-of-the-art decades ago, but as long as the pistols are maintained, they should still fire when the trigger is pulled. When it comes to firepower, the soldier's best friend tends to be their assault rifle. ARs are versatile and powerful, so many soldiers are issued them as their primary weapon. The American soldier can be equipped with several different rifles. The most common are the M4 and M16A2. Both guns are designed to be resilient and powerful. The main difference between the two weapons is the M16A2 has a slightly longer barrel for an extended range. The North Korean soldier is normally issued a Chinese assault rifle. Most often, they're given the Type 56 or Type 63. Both weapons resemble the AK-47. They're slightly bulkier than the US rifles, but are reliable and accurate. However, like the pistols, it's important to note that the North Korean soldier tends to be issued much older weapons. It would be very unfortunate in a battle if the soldier before you did not take good care of the weapon, as it could lead to misfiring or jamming at an inconvenient time. Really, what it comes down to is the US soldier has one of the richest and most powerful nations in the world backing them, while the North Korean soldier is doing the best with what they have. The American soldier has the advantage in terms of health, fitness, and lifestyle. They have more protection to their head and body, while also being issued more modern combat technology. The North Korean soldier would be going into a fight malnourished, with no body armor, and old or heavily used weapons. It would seem that if an American soldier and a North Korean soldier found themselves in a battle, there would be a clear victor. But let us know what you think in the comments. If you're in the mood for some more military comparisons, there's always this video here. Or if you'd like to know more about how the US military tech holds up against another country, there's this video here. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.